So here's the thing. OKRs become this rat's nest of to-do lists on steroids if you're not careful. We need a way to organize our OKRs to make sure that they all are aligned to strategy and they cascade down correctly. Here's how we do it. We should be able to take an organization and capture their overall strategic intent. We do that through a strategy map and weightings. From there, we can determine what are the top level, those 36,000 feet, big picture strategic OKRs, corporate objectives, and then cascade those down to what each core value stream is, or you'd think of those as being departments. So department one has different strategic objectives that it needs to work against in order to achieve the overall corporate success. So we should be able to do that cascade down. Each department responds to these overall strategic OKRs. And then we can test it. What we can do is take a look to see some of the parts. If we do all of the objectives detailed at the department level, do we achieve the corporate level objectives? Once we've done that, we still have, now we've got alignment top down. We still have the problem of making sure we don't have overlapping or duplicate objectives where department one, two, and three are all working on the same thing. So we need to do a second test, and that test checks for alignment across those departments to make sure that we don't have what I call overlaps or underlaps. Overlaps is when we both think we need to do something, and underlaps is when neither of us do, but someone should. And there's ways to reconcile those differences. Once we've got that done, it's a repeating system, depending on how big your organization is. We can take each department and cascade those down to teams using the same framework we used before, then do the same test. If all those teams achieve their goals, would the department achieve its goal? And then make sure that we don't have any overlaps or underlaps at the team level. So in this way, we can make sure that we're doing the cascade correctly and not suffering from the broken telephone. And secondly, make sure that we have alignment across those teams. What does that mean? What now means if leadership needs to change its strategy for some reason and changes their strategic OKRs, we can immediately understand what the impact is on Department 3. And then in turn, we can figure out what the impact is for each of the teams that are part of Department 3. So that way we have that agility in the organization where we can quickly react to changes. Or the opposite. If we're falling short on our OKRs for the team, we can understand the consequences at the department level and from there at the overall strategy level. Hopefully that answers a question for you of how we keep this alignment in place.